Hello and welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. I am Shivam Vijay. Today in this video, I am going to give a demo on Universal Embedded Trainer with MCU type daughter board. So in this trainer, we are going to compile and perform and download the different types of hex file or hex codes to the MCU type of memory flash, and then we execute the programs accordingly on the different segments with the trainer board already provided on the trainer board. Then we can check the how MCU performs and how MCU is programmed with the embedded trainer. So this is our embedded trainer with the IC8089C51RD2, and the order code for this embedded trainer is 43501. You can use this order code to check the specification and to read out about the all segments and all queries about it. And you can purchase it from our website, which is www.tescaglobal.com. So this is the complete setup box. I will explain you all the different parts and segments provided on this trainer board. And this is the cable of RS232 9-pin DB type connector to communicate the complete interface of PC. Software and other regarding accessories also provided with this trainer kit. Now we are going to move on to all the description about the different parts and composition on this trainer kit. Then we follow the all components with the doing the programming and practicals. So this is the complete setup board of embedded trainer with MCU 8089C51RD2. The main CPU is the 8089C51RD2 operating at 12 MHz approximately. And this is compatible for 8051 instruction and 3-bit 16-bit timer counters, 256 8-bytes scratchpad RAM. 9 interrupt source with 4 priority levels are provided. High speed architecture is and 64 kilobytes on chip flash programming data memory. This is a dual data pointer and can be interfaced with the SPI master slave mode, and 8-bit clock prescaler also provided. The ISP programming or in-application programming facility is also provided with this kit. Onboard applications are provided, different type of onboard applications in which 8 LEDs to display digital output are provided here. 8 switches to give the digital input indicated by LEDs. The LED indicators are at this to on and off, and these are the on-off switches for 8 different types of LED logic inputs. 16x2 alphanumeric LCD backlight display is also provided. This is LCD display at which we will see different outputs on different components. And this is the I2C compatible 24C51 EP ROM of 64 KB, and DS1307RTC with suitable battery is also provided. And I2C ROM is provided with this, and 4 channel 8-bit ADC and 1 channel 8-bit DAC using PCFET591IC, and also temperature sensor like LM35 is provided here, and also DS18B20 is also provided for temperature sensing. 24 IO lines provided on a 26 pin FRC connector for external interface. We will use an external module with this in this video. And also we have onboard supply of -12V, +12V, ground and +5V. All ICs are mounted in IC sockets, and this is attractive ABS panel enclosure. User manual is also provided for all types of different understanding and study of different modules and different IC programs. This is the user manual, which comes with the 43501. And in this is the block description of all the blocks different mounted on the trainer board, and this is the CPU card description at which all the switches and different reset modules and other components are provided and described in the block diagram section. After that, this is the introduction and complete features of about the MCU, which is 8089C51, and you can read out all the different modules and different details about the IC, which is the programmable flash IC. This is the pin diagram configuration also provided in the user manual. All the pin descriptions are given in the user manual to read out and to study in detail. After that, we have also included register information in this section, and hardware description of all the LEDs or all the pins are provided of MCU51. These are all the hardware description of all the pins and all the voltages and other working of these pins. This is the switch position and programmable switch positions, and you have to select all the different switches for all different programs. These are the sample program codes. Codes will be provided with this complete setup, and this are the jumper notification for ADC and DAC working. And this is the switches position, RS switch 5 and switch 4 to communicating. We have to select RS switch 5 RX and switch 4 TX to the right side for programming downloading, and for working with the execution you have to put this switch on the right left side. This is the software details. The software we are going to use here is Atmel's Flip, because the IC is compatible with the Atmel software. So we are using this software of ISP programming to download and buffer the hex file in the complete MCU. Then we execute the program from the hex file and see how the IC works and different sensors and other components work with this IC. So now we are going to move for programming section, and all the other details or extra details are provided in this user manual to deeply study with the embedded circuits. So we are now going to start the programming for UAT MCU. First of all, we have to power on the trainer board. The power switch is provided on the upper side of this trainer kit. Properly connect 220 volt AC power supply source and turn on this switch. The trainer board is now in on condition, you can see. Now for communicating and programming, we have to use this serial cable, but as if now, if you have a COM port, you can easily connect the serial cable's other end to the COM port, but I am using a USB to serial converter for this, so that as if my PC does not support communication port or 9 pin D-type connector port, so I have to use the USB to serial connector for this. Now the one end will be connected to RS232 connector of this trainer board, and the USB to serial converter will be connected by USB port on the PC. Now after connecting this, first check your COM port, at which COM port your USB to serial connector is showing. So we will go to manage section, opening device manager, and at device manager the ports, COM ports will be showing for this. Now we have to properly connect the USB to serial. Here you can see, as I connected USB to serial CH340, it is at COM3. So we need to remember COM3. We will use this COM3 on our software. So we have to use the Atmel's Flip 3.4.7 version, which is already installed in my PC. The software will be provided with the complete setup, so that you can easily use this software to programming of MCU51. So we will on this Atmel Flip. Now this is the complete main window, at which you have to first select the device. On this device, select the device. The device that we are using on this IC, on this trainer board, is 8089C51RD2. So we'll select this device, press OK, and we will load hex file for this. The already generated hex files will be provided with this in this folder, or this is the software and program installation software folder. In this, these are the code for 8051 IC, and these are the different already generated program or codes. So we will first start with 7 segment. So as you open the 7 segment folder, you will find release folder. Open the release folder, you will find the main .hex file. So this hex file need to be burned on the main IC. Now The file has been loaded here. You can see hex file pressed. The window will show you the file status. And now we will start communicate this. So before communicating, you have to make sure some things that on should be in the well condition on the trainer board. So we now move to the trainer board that we need to complete all fulfill conditions. So this is our daughter board. For communicating with the PC, make sure switch S4 and switch S5 is at the right position in the right side, and also the switch 3 in the on position. The LED status will give you the status of switch that it is on or off. Now press reset once and then press connect on the software. So now we move on to the software. Here the COM3 will be our serial to USB COM port for this, and whatever the COM port your PC suggest for this. And we have select the COM port 3 here. Baud rate should be 9600, and then you have to press connect. Now I'm going to press connect. Here if you find timeout error, again press reset and quickly press connect. This should be need to done 3 or 4 times, then you will get proper connections, because the RAM memory has some internal register value that is not satisfied. Here you can see in 3 tiers we have communicated our PC, and the COM3 and 9600 is showing that the IC is communicated with this software. Now file has already in the burn position, so in the buffer, so now we have to press this run button so that our flash will be now programming. So first it will erase flash, then check blank, and then program the flash memory of the MCU. Verify pass will be the signal that your program has been completely pressed and programmed to the IC. Now we will move to daughter board, and for checking the programmed IC, we first turn off the switch 3 and move both the switches to the left side again and press reset. Now that we have downloaded the program of 7 segment LED, so we have to turn on the 5 to 7 dip switches on the switch 1. So I am turning on 5, 6 and 7 switch on the dip switches, and as I turn on, the program inserted in the IC is showing the display on 7 segment LED, which is good. The program is already coded for this to display a good in characters of 4 digit 7 segment LED. So our program has been downloaded and it is working with the 7 segment LED using MCU. For the next program setup, we will do any of the setup from this chart. Here all the switch position and switch details are given in this table, or jumper position are also given in this table. You can use these jumpers and the switch position to use with the different programming segments. Now we will do the programming of, let us say we will buffer the program of DS18B20 temperature sensor program. So for this, the switch position of switch 1 dip switch for 1, 2 and 3 dip switches should be on, and 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8 should be in off condition. On dip switch 2, we have to turn on 3 and 4 dip switch for I2C communication or I2C ROM, and 1 and 2 should be in off position. Switch 3 should be on for the temperature sensor. Jumper positions are not required for this. Now we are move on to the programming section. Before that, again turn this switches to right side, turn switch 3 on and press reset. This switch 3 is for daughter board, and switch 3 mentioned in the chart is this one for the temperature sensor. So we have to on this, turn on this switch for DSB20 sensor. Now we'll load the hex file on the PC for temperature sensor DSB. So we'll search. This is the DS18B20 temperature sensor file, hex file. This should be pressed here. Now we'll press run to erasing the flash and to programming the flash. If the programming has some error or does not complete its programming, then again communicate the device completely and then run the program again or execute the program again. Here, as you can see, this it's taking too long time because there is communication issue for this. So we will close this and again communicate the program because the timeout error is showing. Reset the device and communicate. After communicating, we will run the program. Flash will be erased and then blank checking and blank check pass or programming the flash memory will start and programming will done in a few seconds. Checksum error is provided here. So we will again load the hex file and try to run it again. So there is some error. We have to find out the error. Now we will do the next sample program, which is we will select ADC DAC program here. So we can see the ADC and DAC values on the LCD screen. For this we have to turn on 1, 2 and 3 on switch 1 for turning on the LCD display. 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8 displays should be in off condition. Or shift at switch 2, we have to turn on 3 and 4 switches for I2C communication or the ROM memory, and 1 and 2 should be in off position. Here switch 3 should be off and we not need to on the switch 3, and 2 and 3 are the jumper position for jumper 5, and jumper 6 position is not required. So we will communicate and do all fulfill the conditions for this setup and this program. And before programming, make sure on the device you have to turn on again these switches to right side, so programming will on and switch 3 is on. Switch 3 in the chart is about for temperature sensor, so this switch 3 is in the off position and this switch 3 is for the daughter board, and these are the ADC and DAC terminals, in which 4 are the ADC terminals and 1 is the DAC terminal for analog output from digital input, and this is the analog input to digital output. So digital output will be display on is this LCD. So we will select the program in the buffer files from the program menu. So we will load hex file for this, and this is the ADC DAC program project. Open this, open release folder and press select main. Hex file will be pressed. Now we again have to communicate the software or the device. Press reset quickly and press connect. If you find any error, then again try out this complete procedure. Now we'll launch the selected above operations for erasing file. Then blank check and programming the flash. The MCU will be programmed with this software and we will see output of ADC and DAC on the daughter board and trainer board. The programming will done in 15 seconds. The messages are given on the lower left corner of this programming window. After you get verify pass, the all segments are in green and our program has been completely downloaded to the MCU. Now we will see the ADC and DAC configurations on the trainer board. So first of all, we have to turn these switches to the left side again and remove the switch, depress the switch SW3 and press reset. When you press reset, this will give you configure error because at switch 2, I2C buttons are not in on condition. So we will turn on 3 and 4 and again press reset. Now PCF8591 is now on, ADC and DAC IC is completely on. So we will provide 4 single-ended analog inputs, 5 volts or any other volts from the trainer board, and values of all the different analog inputs in digital form is showing at all the 4 channels. Now I am using this patch code to provide 5 volts on the analog inputs. For using the AI1, make sure the jumper J6 is at 2 and 3 position, or you can provide any external input, but you have to provide ground also for this. Now as I touch this patch code on the AI1 terminal, the value of AI1 is 255, is completely stable for this, so that the value of 5 volts in digital form is 255 for this PC. Here you can see the value is 255 on this AI1 channel. Now similarly, I will use this patch code on AI2. So the value at AI2 is now 255. All the values can be easily seen. So you can provide any digital analog input to these terminals and you will get the digital output on these AI1 channels. AI out channel can be also calibrated and seen on a DSO by using the patch codes, and you can get a ramp output in a very low frequency so that the output of the analog value can be easily visible by digital configurations on the DSO and any CRO. So the complete trainer board is also compatible for different types of interface modules like traffic light module, elevator setup module, stepper motor module, and different types of module we have used with this video or with this segment of different types of embedded trainer. So you can use different type of embedded trainer or embedded interface modules. We have a long list of different types of modules. You can check the specification also about that. So for this, I am using this traffic light module for the interfacing with this MCU IC, so that you can understand how the MCU IC will work for different types of interfacing. So this is a traffic light module in which a single square of any cross is given for the brief idea, and these are the red, yellow and green LEDs to give the start and stop signals for this for the vehicles, and to left, right and all the different types of commands are provided. This works on the two basic IC, and we are using a 26 FRC pin connector to communicate this with the 26 IO lines of the main board. So we will first connect this connector. Make sure the connector groove should be matches the one number pin of the pink line should be in the proper matching with the daughter board and main interface board. Now this should be connected in proper condition with the 26 pin IO line of CN13, and as I connect it, the LEDs are now in blinking. Now we will press the program to the IC for the traffic light module, which is a completely generated code with this PC, and then we see how the traffic light module interfaces with the MCU. Now we will load the hex file for traffic light module interface. So we have provided the traffic light interface module file in the codes also. So this is the project for traffic light. Select this, release, open this folder, you will find out main file. So file, hex file has been passed here. Now we will communicate the device again Here device has been communicated. Make sure for communicating all the switches in the, after communicating the device, we will run the setup. This will program the flash. So our program has been completely downloaded to the MCU. Now we will see the working of interface, traffic light interface with the MCU on the board. So right now the processor in the communicating mode, so we will turn out this from communicating mode and press reset. As I press reset, the working of the traffic light interface is now started. Here you can see, again I will start from the reset. First of all the paths north, south and east, west are in the stop position. Now south and north can be go straight from this traffic light or from this circle. Now the all paths are in the stop position. South one can go left and north one can go left also. Similarly, now west and east in the straight direction can be go, and north and south is in stop mode. So this is how the traffic light working here. Now you can see west can be go to north and south ones can be go to right. So this is the time delay is for the short duration for explaining purpose. The time delay and the other difference between all the different light conditions can be changes accordingly to the programming. So this is for the example and to understanding purpose for the study. So this is how interfacing with the traffic light module of UET embedded trainer with MCU on the daughter board. So this is how we use the MCU from different interfaces. Also there are some more interface modules you can use with this. So this was the brief description about the trainer kit and how to use the trainer kit and how to program the trainer or the MCU flash memory with different already generated codes. So traffic light segment interface is also you can see in this. So interfacing with different types of modules can be also done because the trainer board can easily compatible with different types of interface boards like stepper motor, elevator setup motor and modules, and also there are some more modules for different types of LEDs and segments, and which you can communicate and do the programming of different types of modules with this trainer kit. So in this video I have tried to explain the working of this, all the switches and different type of diff switches and conditions to fulfill with the setup, so that you can easily communicate and download the program and then see the working of MCU. So this is it for this video. You can use the user manual for complete detailed instruction and detailed information about the MCU 8051 here. And while working with this kit, if you find more difficulties, you can contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited for all types of supports. Thank you.